start to take your mask off.
Too much trouble taking off.
Lord of
Lord of all creation, Mary, did you know? Good morning. Welcome to Holy Family. We're glad you're here with us. As we prepare to encounter our Lord Jesus in word and sacrament on the fourth Sunday of Advent, we pray that our worship may not only bring honor and glory to God, but be a source of special blessing for ourselves, our loved ones, and our whole community. My name is Tom Kazanowski. I will serve as your lecturer today. The Mass intention today is for George and Alice Fotopoulos. The presider is Father Bill. Before we begin Mass, we invite you to check in on your favorite social media before silencing your device. It's one simple way we can share our faith.
Please join in our gathering hymn, Sing Out Earth and Skies, number 545. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with
your spirit. Sing out earth and skies. What a great peppy way to start Mass after a fabulous beginning before Mass. So, the gift of music that moves the heart and soul. We're here to celebrate two spectacular women in the Bible, not all guys. And one of the women has a speaking role. That's not usual in the Bible. But these are two remarkable women. And it says about, as we wrap up the season of Advent, they kind of encapsulate the whole theme, where we've been, where we're going, the importance of faith. So we want to listen well to these, to that situation that happens with them. We begin by acknowledging our sins and asking the Lord to open our hearts and give us His grace. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come to us this morning in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And you will come again in glory with salvation for all your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the messenger and angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, For he lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Micah. Thus says the Lord, you, Bethlehem, Ephrathah, too small to be among the clans of Judah. From you shall come forth for me one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose origin is from old, from ancient times. Therefore, the Lord will give them up until the time when she who is to give birth has born, and the rest of his kindred shall return to the children of Israel. He shall stand firm and shepherd his flock by the strength of the Lord, in the majestic name of the Lord his God, and they shall remain, for now his greatness shall reach to the ends of the earth. He shall be in peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, when Christ came into the world, he said, sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me. In holocaust and sin offerings you took no delight. Then I said, as is written of me in the scroll, behold, I come to do your will, O God. First, he said, sacrifices and offerings, holocausts and sin offerings. You neither desired nor delighted in. These are offered according to the law. Then he says, behold, I come to do your will. He takes away the first to establish the second. By this will, we have been consecrated through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leapt for joy. Blessed are you who believed that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. So we start the scriptures this morning talking about a little backwater town, I guess we'd call it. Poor little Bethlehem. Too small to be among the clans of Judah. But out of that little town, something wonderful is going to happen. That's where the Christ was to be born. So we start with simplicity, insignificant location. And then we have two women who walk onto the stage. And they're in very different circumstances. Elizabeth is well along in years, prayed mightily to have a child, who was childless. And then her husband had an angelic visitation to say that Elizabeth would be with child, and this child would be important. But she was old, way beyond childbearing years. But happy to be called to be a mother. Woman of faith. And then the other woman. She's not married, so she shouldn't be with child. But she is. Another moment of grace. Another moment of God working his plan, not according to our plan. And perhaps it's out of hospitality and care for her elder cousin that Mary goes to visit her. Perhaps she wanted to be somewhere wish you to receive understanding and not condemnation. She was with child, she had no husband. And so she goes to Elizabeth and the wonderful greeting, who am I, how am I so blessed that the mother of my Lord would come to me? So we start today's gospel as we wrap up Advent with these two people, one of whom had been waiting forever for God to touch her, let her have a child, and the other young one whose whole being was open to God without any plan. She wasn't planning to be the mother of the Messiah. Just a young woman who loved God, was open to whatever God wanted. And these two come together in this really sacred moment. And they share affection and support for one another. Now, for them, this was a sacred time that wasn't sort of compact all at once. And when it was over, they'd move on to something else. You know, kind of transactional. This thing will happen and then we'll get busy with some other thing. You know, sometimes we're looking forward to the 25th so that we'll get to the 26th. You know? And the dishes will end up being done and the wrappings will end up being disposed and the house will regain some order. Christmas will be done. But that's not what these women thought. They didn't think that Elizabeth, when I have this child, I'm done with that and everything will be wonderful. Mary just thought, God has asked me to do this unbelievable thing. And I don't know where that's going, but it surely won't end when I give birth. See, they both had this awareness that God was in their lives and that they were important to God as he was to them. And this was a sacred moment in that relationship, but it wasn't the whole relationship, it was part of it. And I sometimes fear that we make our religious moments transactional. You know, when it's done, it's done. It's done. Move on to the next thing. As opposed to, in my life of faith, this was a special moment to celebrate the feast of next week, the incarnation. A special moment to review and renew and strengthen what's there and doesn't stop on the 25th. It goes on and on and on because God dwells with us always. And we have these special moments of grace that we call holy days that help us focus on the wonder of God's love. And so is this week one of those special moments. You know? And we have to be careful, I think, that we know that it's a special moment, not just something neatly wrapped up in a package that we'll be done with. This Lent, this Advent, for some reason, my head kept returning to a book I read a long, long time ago called The God Who Comes. It was a book about Old Testament theology, as I remember it. And the author kept noticing how all through the Old Testament, God keeps coming to us. He keeps coming to his people, sometimes with joy and pride, and sometimes with exasperation beyond anything. Because people are making him crazy again, if you can say that about God. He invested so much in them, and they just... they couldn't stay with the game. They'd go off and worship other gods. But he kept coming to them and coming to them. Now, the very beginning of creation, he's there. Then all of those moments of the Old Testament, that history, God keeps coming back. When they let him down, he comes back to them. When they run away from him, he calls them back. He's always with them. He's always with us. Sometimes we let him down. We go off the game plan. We get preoccupied with other stuff. But he's always there to call us back. Elizabeth, Mary knew that. They had this wonderful, profound faith that made God so real, even though the things they were experiencing were scary. Scary for Elizabeth to be well along in years, and all of a sudden, she's with child. What is going on? But she knew God was part of it. Mary, an angelic messenger. That's a nice way to start. You know, an angel pops in and says, can we have a chat? But when the angel's gone and the reality is still there, what do we do with that? Can I really know that God is here? And that's the God who comes to us. In all of our ages and all of our stages, God is always coming to us. And so this week we prepare for this magnificent coming at Christmas that we celebrate. He actually entered our world as one of us. But it doesn't end at midnight on the 26th. It starts again. The invitation to know God's presence again. The invitation to think about the wonders of the feast, that the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, so that we would know God's love. As with that little town chosen, Bethlehem Ephrathah, tiny town, great things happened. So in our tiny lives, wonderful things happened. We have to be aware that our God always comes to us because of the great love he has for us. So as we come down the home stretch with all of the wonderful, busy things that happen before Christmas, you know, the shopping, the cooking, the wrapping, the parties, the plans, all of those wonderful things, a great grace to remember that this happens not because of a holiday slash feast we call Christmas, but because of the reality that is behind that name. All of these happen because our God wants to come to us all the time, every season, every holy day. And our task, our challenge, is to see in these feasts and holy days moments of grace for us to focus. Next week to focus that the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Always, always with us. That's Emmanuel, God with us. We renew the wonders of that this week, but it doesn't stop on the 25th. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Mindful of God's great love for us, we now present our needs and petitions to God.
For the church, that our hearts, like Elizabeth's, may leap for joy as we recognize the Lord's presence with us and the people in the events of our lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who were injured or lost homes or businesses in the recent tornadoes, that God will heal their wounds, keep them safe from further harm, and help them obtain the resources that they need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill, that God will bring an end to the pandemic, restore the sick to health, and strengthen all caregivers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who find the season difficult, that they may receive the comfort, consolation, and support they need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, that they may rest in peace with the Lord in heaven, especially at this Mass, for George and Alice Fotopoulos. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the petitions received on our parish prayer line, and for the personal needs and intentions we offer in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, we offer you these petitions with great hope as we look forward to the celebration of the birth of your Son. We make our prayer in the name of Jesus, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Put those down here.
Now.
Let us pray now, sisters and brothers, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, our loving Father. May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him. The Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so the angels and archangels with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory is without end we acclaim. And to always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you
therefore, Holy Father, As we celebrate the memorial of Christ your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith is known to you alone. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our own earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs and all your saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor are yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your Spirit, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity throughout the world, for you are Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with
your spirit. Let's share with one another some gesture of peace.
Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Meek and the lowly,
Let us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast of our salvation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's Nativity, for he lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen. This week there'll be two occasions for confession, Tuesday night and Wednesday night, 6:30 to 8, in the reconciliation room off the corridor and in the chapel around the corner there. So Tuesday and Wednesday night, 6:30 to 8. In spite of the fact that we're wearing masks again, which isn't great news, the good news is our altar servers are back. Yeah. We're happy to welcome them. And today, Skylar Novak begins for the first time. So thank you, Skylar, and thank you very much for helping me. On Christmas, the one collection to be taken up will support the health and retirement of the priests of the Archdiocese of Boston. Envelopes of this collection are available at the doors of the church. Your custom generosity will be greatly appreciated. Members of our Appalachian Service Project team are selling raffle tickets after Mass today. Four lucky families will receive a reserved pew and two parking spaces at the Christmas Mass of their choice. If it snows out or rains out, that's a great award. Proceeds go to their service trip to West Virginia this summer. Serious note, Christmas is a time of joy, but it can be stressful for those with addictions and their families. I Thirst Spiritual Healing Ministry, sponsored by the Archdiocese, is here to help. Trained parish counselors are ready to walk with and support all those experiencing difficulty. You need not be alone. For more information, please stop by the I Thirst table at the front entrance of the church. And right after Mass, you're invited to the chapel to enjoy a 15-minute guided Advent meditation, where you'll be led through an imaginative prayer experience. Give yourself a gift of peace by staying for just a few minutes in the chapel right after Mass. And we think about prayer, we think about saying prayers, we think about kind of just chatting with God. And another prayer experience is this kind of putting yourself in the situation in the scripture. You know, what was it like, you know, to try to get the sounds, the smells, the crowd, the noise, whatever that might be, and just enrich the reality of your prayer life with that. So right in the chapel, right after Mass, 15 minutes. If you've never done it, try it. It's an enrichment, a way to enrich your prayer life. And just before Mass, I was out waiting for the choir to finish their concert. And we started Mass, and I don't think we said thank you properly, did we? We didn't say thank you properly. Thank you very much. The gift of music is such a blessing. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Mass is ended. We go now in peace. Thanks be to God.
Because our concert and pageant were canceled, as we look forward to Christmas, we present a special song.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Forever and ever, hallelujah, hallelujah.